Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll show you how I try and multiply my African violet plants. I had made a previous video in which I had shown you how to plant an extra sapling of African violet plants. That experiment did not succeed, but then that taught me a few important facts to consider while trying to reproduce African violet plants. That is the soil. This is the original pot in which had come when I had ordered for my African violet plant. I haven't changed it, and you can see the pot contains cocoa peat as the potting medium and probably vermicompost along with it. So when I planted the previous portion sapling of African violets, I actually made a mixture of various soils, and that probably became too heavy. So in today's experiment, I'll try and see if I can reproduce an African violet from a single leaf. So what I have over here is plain cocoa peat. Okay, this is not homemade cocoa peat. This is store-bought cocoa peat. I'll link it down below. And fungicide and a small portion of a bottle. See, it has drainage holes inside it. I had planted another sapling in it before transferring it to a bigger pot. So I'll use these three. So the procedure is very simple. First, I'll take some fungicide and mix it along with the cocoa peat. Okay, very little quantity. This much is enough. I can't see any stick around, so I'm mixing it with my hand. This will prevent any kind of fungal infection. And once I have mixed it thoroughly, I'll stuff this container using the cocoa peat. Okay, so the next thing that I'll do is I'll take leaf cuttings from this plant. Let me put this aside. I'll show you exactly what type of leaves I'll take. So you can see the lower leaves. These lower leaves are the mature ones, and the top ones are the younger ones. You can see light green and this is deep green. So these are the leaves that you need. I'll take my paper cutter and I'll gently cut out the leaves like this. Okay. The more you dress your plant, the more it is going to grow. Another one. I think I'll take this crooked one as well. I've taken three leaf cuttings. I have tried to grow these off camera in water as well, but I haven't quite succeeded. So this time, let's try with cocoa peat before I finally give up. So what you can see, I've already made an angular cut. Let's make it more angular. Okay. So this is the cut we are looking for. You see, angular cut. You need to shorten the stalk as much as possible. Okay. This is another one. And this is the third one. So usually what people do is they stick it right into the soil. But as I would for succulents, I always allow cuttings that I take from any plant for that matter to at least dry up a little bit. If not for an entire day, then at least for half an hour before I stick it into the soil. So I let this be while I prepare my cocoa peat. And for my cocoa peat, what I'll do is I'll take some water and I'll moisten it. Cocoa peat absorbs water really well and holds it for quite some time. So that is why Cocopeat is considered the ideal medium for seed starting as well as for starting cuttings. And I have been using cocopeat for different gardening experiments for the past, say, 5 years. So I can vouch by cocopeat. I recently made an experiment to see if it's possible to grow jade plants from leaves, and that experiment succeeded. I used both soil and cocopeat as the mediums, and both yielded good results. But the cocopeat's growth was, the leaf going in cocopeat was far better. So cocopeat is the go-to product when I try to multiply my plants. I'll put some more water. The best advantage of cocopeat rather is that once you water, you don't need to water for the next many days. At least for the next 2-3 days, depending upon the weather, you don't need to water cocopeat. Okay, so I'll press this down a little bit. You see the excess water has already drained out because this is thoroughly drenched. Now I'll make 3 sections like this for my leaf cuttings, and I'll come back to you. Okay, so here are my 3 leaf cuttings. They haven't dried out completely, but much of the sap has already oozed out. Okay, so like I showed you, I made 3 crevices for my leaves. So I'll just stick them in like this, in an angular way. Okay, this is one. I'll try and space them out as much as possible. This is another one. And then this is the third one. This is the way you stick in your African violet soil, African violet leaves in a media and wait. Okay, this is not an overnight process. It will at least take 3 to 3.5 weeks to develop roots first. So you need to be patient, and that is what gardening entails. It entails a lot of patience. And I would like to show something. That is, few days back I had casually stuck a leaf that had fallen off this African violet plant into the media of this particular soil. Okay, so this was the leaf, and when I took it out, you can see, I don't know if it's visible. I'll try and focus. See, these are the new roots already growing out of the leaves. So I can only hope that this experiment that I'm doing succeeds. I'll stick this in here. Let's keep this separate. You need to secure the, this one is coming off. You need to secure the potting media around the cutting so that there is a constant supply of moisture, and eventually you will get your African violet seedlings. Okay, so I'll have to use my paper cutter. Okay. So here we have 4 African violet leaves. We are going to keep this in full sunlight and water the cocopeat only when it dries out, not before that. Otherwise, it might lead to rotting despite me having used the fungicide. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll keep you updated with this, with the updates of this experiment. Stay tuned to my channel, and for any queries, feel free to comment below. The links of all the products that I have used in this video will be there below in the description box. Take care and happy gardening.